This show was first broadcast on Free FM 89.0, Hamilton, New Zealand's community access radio station. For more information on our station and the wide range of programs, visit freefm.org.nz.
Hey, Dad.
Johnny, can you help me with this iPhone?
Oh, Dad, just go to UB.
UB, Hamilton's only dedicated Apple authorized reseller and service provider for all your Apple needs, including iPads, iPhones, portables and desktops. Come talk to the experts at UB, Te Awa at the base. To keep up to date with the latest news and announcements, like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter at UBNZ or head into store so we can help you be the best you can be.
And now, #RadioNZ.
Welcome to Hashtag Radio. I'm Fred McAwesome.
And I'm V8 Maddie.
And we are brought to you by UB. You can check them out online at Facebook. Just check out UBNZ or follow them on Twitter.
At UBNZ.
Yeah. Also, if you're in Hamilton around about, why don't you head out to the base and check out all the awesome Apple goodness out there at their store and location out there.
Yes, indeed.
And on this week's Uncultured Roundup of social media, web, tech and gaming, we've got quite a bit of stuff up this week.
Little bit gaming heavy, but I mean the 2014 Game Awards are currently on.
They're on right now.
It's only fitting that we're a little bit game heavy.
Yeah.
For a change.
So we're gonna cover off the Game Awards later on in the show. So at least we've got some results to talk about then.
We will.
And we've also got some heaps of news about Sony this week.
Yeah, big week for the Sony crew.
In fact, later on in the show, we're actually going to have Krista, the boss of Sony New Zealand, in. And
or the boss of PlayStation New Zealand.
Yep, boss of PlayStation New Zealand. And we'll also have a chat a bit later on, actually coming up, about the event that Sony are helping us out with.
Yes.
Yeah. Now, also, you'll notice there's just the two of us this week.
Just the two of us.
Just the two of us.
I almost wanted to sing that. But
Carice McAwesome couldn't be with us this week. She is currently starting a free-range chicken farm.
Yeah.
Usually we make things up.
Eggs are important.
Yeah, usually we make things up for when Carice isn't here, but that is actual fact. She is currently building a chicken hutch.
A chicken coop?
A chicken coop. Chicken hutch? Chicken
a hutch? Coop. A coop? Yeah. Rabbits live in hutches.
Okay. We'll roll with that.
We'll roll with that.
Yeah. So Carice can't be with us, so we're not going to be covering off the news this week as we usually do, but we'll just cover it off during the show as we go along.
So hi, Carice.
Hopefully she's live tweeting the show for us.
I'm sure she's listening.
Yeah. Now, as we did say earlier, Sony PlayStation New Zealand are helping us with an event this week.
Yeah.
Next week, Monday. Yeah. So if you're listening to the podcast, you've missed out.
You've missed the boat.
Yeah, but this coming up this Monday, we're supporting and helping organise an hour of code.
An hour of code, which is obviously about coding, computer stuff.
Now, we talked about this last year, and this year we've decided to jump on board and actually get involved in it rather than just sort of whinging about the fact that not enough people are learning code or not enough people are giving the opportunity to people who are interested in coding
a chance to learn it. Or at least giving them the opportunity to know what it is.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, rather than just playing games and using computers and software, it's... Here's what it is and how it works.
Yeah, exactly.
The nuts and bolts.
So if you've ever been interested in how code works, how do you build a game, how do you build an app, how do you write a website, all of these things.
Yeah.
But, you've got no knowledge whatsoever on how to do it, it's the perfect opportunity to come along for 1 hour and get the basics sort of given to you, told, and then if you're further interested, there'll be people there to tell you how you would go about learning it as a career.
Yeah, taking the next steps, getting all edumacated.
That's the one. And Sony PlayStation have kindly jumped on board with us because they obviously see the benefit of this as well in their industry. And they're going to they've given us a heap of stuff to give away at this event.
That's right. PlayStation goodies, folks.
Yeah. So we've got games, we've got drink bottles, we've got all sorts of stuff to give away thanks to PlayStation. So massive shout out to PlayStation NZ for that. So we're actually organising this with Vision College Hamilton.
Yep.
If you're interested in turning up to this, you can just turn up 9 o'clock in the morning on Monday.
Mm-hmm. Where is it?
21 Ruakura Road in Hamilton.
Yes.
East Hams, Ham East.
Yeah,
you always correct me on how I say
towards, East towards Hamilton. The university over that way.
Yeah. Just turn up. It's only an hour out of your day. Tell the boss that you're taking an hour off of personal development.
Yeah, perfect.
Yeah. See, I know how to spin these things.
You're a spin doctor.
Yeah. tell the boss you're taking an hour off of personal development and, pop along and learn some stuff. We're going to be there as well. Me and Carice McCorson will be there. So get to meet us as well.
Yeah.
And being the super online celebrities that we are, I know you want
to
meet us.
Fid's happy to autograph chests.
Yep. Hairy ones. Yeah, make sure if you want to know more information about that, it's on our website, #me.co.nz is all the guts and goss. And yep.
The Hour of Code, Mark Zuckerberg, it's a global thing.
It is a global thing. Last year they broke a record for the largest ever education event, and they're hoping to smash that out of the park this year.
Yeah, so this year they're looking to try and get, 100 million people involved?
Yeah. Which, so, to be honest, it's not hard. It's not going to be hard considering we're not the only Hamilton event, but we're the only one we're going to tell you about. But if you're in Wellington, I know Hack Miram are doing one. The lads from Access Granted are actually involved in helping out with that one.
Yep. Mike and is Raj going to go
along?
I'm
not sure if Raj is involved in it as much, but I know Mike is heavily involved in organising it. So if you're in the Wellington region, check out Hack Miram's website or just Google it. If you want to know if there is a Hour of Code event in your town, if you just head along to code.org, online you can find out anywhere around the world, wherever you are, where you can head along and do an Hour of Code for free.
Nice.
Yeah. So that's awesome.
And if you come along to the one in Hamilton, you might get some PlayStation goodies.
Exactly.
Games and stuff.
Talking about Access Granted.
Access Granted?
Yeah. It's been a massive week for them this week.
They've had a good week.
And it's been massive for #me in general, to be honest.
Yeah.
If you don't know what we're talking about, we announced earlier this week that Access Granted, which is the ICT geeky podcast that comes out of Wellington, which is on the #me podcast network, just got picked up by iHeartRadio.
Yeah.
So
well done, guys.
That's an awesome achievement for these lads. They've been hacking away all year trying to join the rest of us on iHeartRadio. And so that means all of our podcasts off the network are now on iHeart.
Yeah, so you can find #radio on iHeartRadio.
Yep.
You can also find the Access Granted podcast and the Bits of Awesome retro gaming podcast.
And hopefully early next year, our yet-to-be-started gaming podcast will be there as
we're
well.
We're still looking for a name.
Yeah, see, I came up with a name earlier. I'll tell you off of you. I've got an idea.
An idea?
Yep.
Uh-oh.
These things can be dangerous.
we're going to definitely kick that off in the new year, though.
Yeah.
So we'll have a fully gaming dedicated podcast.
Then you won't have to sit through us talking about games on #radio every week.
As much.
We still will be talking gaming, of course. We can't help ourselves. Anyway, we've still got heaps to talk about, including the most unregular weekly segment in New Zealand radio. App of the week. That's coming up as well. You got some news on a massive hacking scandal that happened in the last 7 days.
Yes.
And 20 years of PlayStation.
That's a lot of PlayStation.
That is a lot of PlayStation. So Krista will also be joining us after the break as well. Our first track this week. It's a doozy. One of my favourite bands as well. And an amazing band to see live. Foo Fighters. You're on #.
Flammable light, cold as a mind. starting with a spark and burn into the dark. Now here I go. There is the river I found into the wild under the
know that Free FM is a charity?
Trust Waikato does, and New Zealand Lottery, and the Lion Foundation, and Southern Trust. And every year, these and a swag of other community funders help us make real community radio on Free FM. Cheers for that!
Hashtag Radio NZ.
You're back with Hashtag Radio on Free FM. Now, we've got a bit of information here about a new app. Now, we've often done App of the Week.
Often.
And then it had a long break, and then it came back, and then it was gone, and then it was back, and it was gone.
The most irregular segment on New Zealand radio.
Yeah. We still call it App of the Week, though, because it is a
it
day of the
on
week,
a week. Yeah.
That we
Which maybe we should rename it to It's App of a Week.
Or the occasional app.
Yeah. So anyway, here is it's time for the return of
App of the Week.
This week's App of the Week is actually made for smartwatches.
Oh, is it?
It is.
Ah.
But the 2.0 version of this app, which is called Talk Search.
Okay.
Now, that's Talk as in T-O-R-Q-U-E. Originally made for smartwatches.
Yep.
And what it is an alternative to Google's voice search.
Is it Google Now?
Google Now.
Yep. Now, okay, Google.
Available for Android. You don't have to say, okay, Talk.
Okay.
You can launch it just by shaking your phone.
Okay.
Yeah, so it does work just on your phone now with the new version. So that's why I've brought it up, because it's usable on your phone if you don't have a smartwatch.
Okay.
And it is also good if you do have a smartwatch. The downside for some people will be that the search engine it uses is Bing.
That's an interesting choice of search engine, considering it's developed for a Google device.
Well, it's developed for Android.
Yeah. Well, Google.
Google?
Yeah, Google Android.
I suppose.
Yeah.
But I've been having a play with it. It works really well. You shake your phone, it pops up. The only thing with the phone, though, is because it's made for a smartwatch, is you just get a little square pop-up on the screen.
So is it a widget or is it an app?
It's an app, but it looks more like a widget
because
it pops up. You can set it to come on by shaking your phone.
So if you're in an app already and you do the shake, will it pop up over top of that app?
It will. It'll
pop
up anywhere.
So if you're mid-game, you can go, oh, I need to search that.
Or if you're even Googling something with your browser or something on your phone.
So you could dual search. You can multitask.
You can multitask.
There you go, ladies. See, people think that us men can't multitask. We can now with this tech.
That's right. We can breathe and talk.
Yep.
Now, it's free, of course.
It's our favourite price.
That's our favourite price for any app. And it works well. It does. It's not the same as having a browser. It's not going to be as full featured as Google Now.
Yep.
But for a quick search, if you just want to find out what the weather's doing tomorrow, or if you wake up in the morning want to know whether you need your umbrella.
Yep.
Quick little things.
So what's it called again?
It's called Talk Search.
Talk Search, available on Android everywhere.
That's right.
Awesome.
Type in Talk Search, because if you type Talk, you'll get all sorts of car app things.
You would, do I assume, yeah.
Yeah, which is it's a long way down the list before you find this one, so go Talk Search.
Now, earlier this week, Sony, who's had an awesome week this week, also had a bit of a muck week as well.
Well, yes and no.
I understand this is the movie side of Sony, so Sony Pictures.
Sony Pictures Entertainment. Now, the FBI have actually sent out a malware warning. Now, they didn't name Sony Pictures in the warning, but the timing of the two events pretty much puts them together.
Yeah.
Now, the Sony Pictures Entertainment were hacked. They got hit by a very nasty bit of malware, which actually overwrites data on hard drives, closes down networks. They've had all sorts of information stolen, including personal employee data, copies of passports belonging to actors and crews that are working on film projects, their Outlook email accounts, the whole shebang has been taken. And some of the Sony staff have actually started getting threatening emails now from the hackers, who have given themselves the name GOP.
GOP.
Guardians of Peace.
Now, I know it was rumoured or speculated that the hack may have been done by North Korea. As in retaliation to Sony Pictures releasing or being about to release a movie by Seth Rogen, The Interview.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
I hadn't heard that little conspiracy theory.
Yeah. If you don't know what The Interview is, it's Seth Rogen and that guy that
James
used to be famous.
Franco.
Yeah, him.
He's still famous.
The movie's about them being journalists. They get an interview with Kim Jong-un, and then
the American government try to recruit them to assassinate him while they're there.
Yeah. So naturally, Kim's gone, I'm not happy with this.
There's a lot of angry Kims around.
Yeah. he's not happy about it. And he has apparently, if you believe the speculation,
he's
gone, you will hack these people and punish them for their sins. They can need to leave me alone because I'm quite happy being Ronery.
Yeah, so these guys hacked into Sony Pictures Entertainment, left a list of demands and a little message saying who they were.
Yeah.
And it's going to take a long time for Sony to fix things up. They've also lost copies of unreleased movies.
Yeah.
A lot of this information has already started popping up online.
As it would.
Yeah. So I'm not a fan of people that go around hacking.
No, I like some good... There's good hacking and bad hacking. There's those dickheads who just go out there and hack websites for the fun of it, or hack databases for the fun of it.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's the guys that genuinely hack for political reasons, that are trying to get or punish governments
for a very good cause,
for
maybe.
The good cause, yeah.
It depends on you.
There's a fine line, though, yeah.
What cause is good?
I suppose. If you're in the North Korean government, you probably think this is a good cause.
Absolutely. Because if you don't, you'll get your head chopped off.
Yeah. However, if you're a multinational movie company, you probably wouldn't agree.
That's right. So, yeah, that's been pretty bad for Sony.
But in other news for Sony... it's been a week of a massive milestone for them, for the gaming side of Sony, PlayStation.
Yeah, 20 years of PlayStation.
20 years. I felt old when that announcement came out.
Well, you are old, Fid.
1994, December 3rd, 1994. PlayStation was released in Japan.
Woo!
We didn't get it for a couple of years afterwards, though.
No.
Yeah.
Because I got mine in
96 I got mine.
97. Might have been 97 I got mine.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I got mine in 96.
PlayStation 1. My mum bought it for me for my birthday.
Yeah? I saved up and bought mine myself. I was at high school.
Oh, hardcore.
Yeah.
I was no longer at high school.
No.
But never mind.
Yeah, but I have fond memories of that machine. It's quite... I was thinking about it on the way to the studio today. I mean, as a milestone, think about Sega, who were still around then.
Mm.
They didn't last 20 years.
No.
They came out in 84.
The legend lives on.
Yeah, but they were gone by 99.
Yeah.
So they didn't last 20 years. Sony have lasted 20 years. They've seen companies come and go and die off, and they've sort of become a bit of a mainstay, them and Nintendo, of course.
Yeah. Now, the PlayStation's it's an iconic gaming console, isn't it? I mean, it led the way with so many different features.
Well, I think if you look at history and stuff, it was probably the first successful CD-based console.
Mm.
Before that, like, Sega had a CD unit and all that, but no one had really done a good job of it.
Yeah, I mean, up till then, the big ones had been cartridges.
Yeah.
So to have it come out with a disc, you could fit a lot more data. You could use it for playing your music CDs.
Exactly.
And have pretty colours on the TV screen at the same time.
Yeah. But see, the PlayStation franchise in general has actually always been a bit of a forward-thinking console, where, like, that was the first main console where you could play your music and all that on it as well. But then the next generation, the PS2, was a DVD player as well as a PlayStation, as well as a gaming console, as well as a CD player. And they actually put down the success of the format of DVD down to the PS2. Because,
really?
Yeah, because there were more PS2s in homes than DVD players. And in Japan alone as well.
Yeah, well, it was, I mean...
If you want a format to take off worldwide, if Japan adopts it, the rest of the world will adopt it.
Well, that's the thing. I mean, I haven't even bought a standalone Blu-ray player or DVD player. It's always been a console that I've had there, a gaming console that I've used. So
and it's the same with, we'll see PS3 did exactly the same thing.
Mm.
Blu-ray ended up winning the HD wars, and it wasn't the best format.
No.
I think it was the Panasonic had HD DVD, which was actually a bigger format, could fit more on, but because there was more PlayStation 3s out there than any other console, Blu-ray won the war.
Yay! Yeah.
But anyway, so Sony's celebrating their 20-year anniversary with an amazing console.
Mm.
But it is, okay, the guts of it is just the PS4, and the face of it is just the PS4. But I think it looks awesome.
Yeah, so they're doing the limited edition PS4 console.
Yeah.
In pretty colours.
It's going to be available in your choice of grey or grey.
Yeah.
The same colour grey as the original PlayStation. They're replacing all the PlayStation logos on it with the original PlayStation logo.
Yeah, they've gone old school, retroed it out.
What I thought was really cool is the fine details on it. Like the texture of it is actually 2 circle X square triangle.
Yeah.
And that's the whole texture. And same as the touchpad on the controller.
Now, it's a limited edition globally.
Yeah.
And
12,300 of them.
It's going to cost a bit more than your standard PS4, but it does come with the camera and a stand.
Yeah, the camera and the stand, which usually you'd have to buy separate.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's going to be a bit more pricey. But
I don't think there's any word out yet of how much it's going to cost or how many we're going to get in New Zealand. I wouldn't mind picking that this is going to be an order from Sony only
situation, possibly.
Eh? Not
we'll have to ask PlayStation NZ really nicely to give us one.
Yeah. Well, I see Mashable got one.
Oh, did they?
Yes.
Ooh.
Yeah.
I wonder if they've got any jobs going.
But anyway, because of the 20-year anniversary, Krista from PlayStation going to answer a few questions for us.
He is. We have a catch-up with him now. Thanks for joining us today, Krista. What's the big news?
Well, I'm pleased to announce that PlayStation 4 has been crowned the fastest-selling video games console of the decade in New Zealand and continues to hold the title as the number one next-generation home console.
Why do you think the PS4's been so successful?
Well, with almost 20 years in the making, PlayStation 4 is the fastest-selling video games console of the decade in New Zealand. At PlayStation, we remain focused on our players and continue to innovate, so the socially connected experience at the heart of the PS4 has truly resonated with the gaming fans.
What makes the PS4 different?
At PlayStation, we remain focused on our players and continue to innovate, so the socially connected experience at the heart of the PS4 has truly resonated with the gaming fans.
And what does this announcement mean for the gaming industry?
The interactive games industry is going from strength to strength, and PS4 is a significant driver of this growth. The console hardware category in New Zealand has increased by 92% in value since the release of the 8th generation hardware in 2013, with PS4 accounting for a substantial 46% of the total category value since its launch.
That brings back some memories, that noise, doesn't it?
It does.
So, yeah, I mean, that's Krista telling us basically they're wanting to keep on trucking. They've been going really well. They've got the best-selling console for the last decade.
Yeah.
In New Zealand.
It's amazing.
It is. It does sort of highlight the fact that PlayStation is New Zealand's preferred console.
Yeah, well, you remember at the... Oh, you went there. Asshole move. At the PlayStation 4 launch... It was repeated over and over again that New Zealand's a PlayStation nation. Yeah.
PlayStation nation.
Awesome play on words.
It works nicely.
If you want to know more about sort of the history of the PlayStation franchise, next week, or this week if you're listening to the podcast, the Bits of Awesome podcast, we're going to be doing a bit of a retrospective on the PlayStation.
And that is yourself and Gus.
Yeah, me and Gus are going to have a bit of a chat about it and talk about our memories, and some of the peeps out there on Twitter and Facebook and stuff have actually been tweeting and messaging us with their memories, so we'll go through them. And
cool. Yeah. I might throw a memory in there for you.
You should.
I might.
Yeah.
I'll think about it.
So, yeah, make sure you check out that podcast later in the week on hashtagme.co.nz. And thanks to Krista for letting us know where PlayStation's headed and where you've been. And it's awesome to have him on the show.
I know, he talks really fast.
He does talk very fast.
But that's okay. We'll let him off.
Anyway, we've still got heaps coming up in the show. You've got some not really tech or gaming or social media news, but I think it's worthy of being on Hashtag.
What are you talking about?
Some stuff about Doctor Who and stuff.
Oh, yeah. Doctor Who is awesome.
Yeah, so we're going to give Matt the floor and get his geek on with Doctor Who later. And, of course, we're going to be running down the winners of some of the awards from the Game Awards, which are on right now. And I think we'll also spit out our thoughts on those winners, because we've seen some of the winners and we're not happy.
No, not happy at all.
Yeah. So make sure you stick around. You're on Hashtag, brought to you by Ubi.
Check them out at UBNZ on Twitter. And go see them out at the base, at Tiawa the Base in Hamilton, for all your tasty Apple goodies.
Hey, Dad.
Johnny, can you help me with this iPhone?
Oh, Dad, just go to UB.
UB, Hamilton's only dedicated Apple authorised reseller and service provider for all your Apple needs, including iPads, iPhones, portables and desktops. Come talk to the experts at UB, Tiawa at the base. To keep up to date with the latest news and announcements, like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter at UBNZ or head into store so we can help you be the best you can be.
Hashtag Radio NZ.
You're back with Hashtag Radio, and we're going to talk about Doctor Who.
Yeah.
Calm yourself, don't get too excited.
No, I'm not the biggest Doctor Who. I'm not a Doctor Who hater. I've enjoyed Doctor Who episodes that I've watched. I just don't get as nerdy about it as you do.
It's all the tech.
Passionate.
Imagine having a sonic screwdriver, Fid. The things you could do.
Hmm.
And a TARDIS.
A TARDIS would be ace.
You could fit so much bacon into the TARDIS.
Now you've got me. So you got some Doctor Who news.
Oh, just a little bit of gossip. Recently in an interview with Peter Capaldi, the current Doctor, he suggested that the person to take the lead role after him might be a woman.
Oh, yes.
And there was much speculation about whether or not it was going to be a woman before he was announced.
Oh, okay. I didn't realise that.
Yeah. Now, also in the current series with Peter Capaldi, the on-again, off-again arch-enemy of the Doctor is the Master. Now, he's always been a bloke, but until this season, the Master came back as Missy, a woman.
Now, because in the past, the companions have been both men and women, haven't they?
Yeah. There's usually been one of each.
Yeah.
Or at least a reasonably hot chick.
Yeah.
And a guy that comes and goes.
Yeah. So the companions have been both.
You know what I mean when I say
that. Yeah. But we're yet to see the Doctor change gender.
Quite possibly.
Yeah.
He thinks it would be good for it. And I mean, having the Master come back as Missy, the Mistress, it sort of opens the door for it to say, look, it can be done.
Yeah.
There's a lot of people out there who think the Doctor should always be a guy.
Oh, there's going to be haters no matter what.
I really don't know. It would depend on the actress that was playing the part.
Yeah, it would change the dynamic of the show completely.
It would. Because he's always been a quirky kind of goofball guy. Peter Capaldi's put a bit of a darker spin on it.
Yeah.
And
he's still got that quirky sense of humour, though, from the episodes I've seen.
I like the current Doctor. I like Peter Capaldi. I hope he stays for another series or two.
Yeah.
Although this interview doesn't sound promising.
Yeah. we had the last two Doctors for a decent run each, though, eh?
Yeah, they had a couple each.
Yeah.
I think. I don't know.
I liked the crossover episode last year.
Where they had the three of them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, the fourth in theory. Four in theory, because you had the War Doctor as well.
Yeah. So that's my Doctor Who news anyway.
Yeah.
I know that there are people out there who really don't give a rat's ass.
Yeah.
But it's a cool show, and it's been going for a long time, and there are a lot of big fans out there.
We started watching Doctor Who from the very beginning last year.
The beginning of the new seasons?
No, the beginning of the beginning.
From the black and white ones?
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, we started watching them right from word go. Like, of course, there was the missing episode, which you can watch, but they've been pieced together with the audio and a lot of still images.
Yeah.
But we still watched them. I think we managed to get almost through the first 5 or 6 years of it.
Yeah, well, it started out a lot darker. The comedy's come in later years.
Yeah.
You know. Bow ties are cool.
Yeah, fezzes are cool.
And fezzes are cool. So that's my Doctor Who.
Yeah. I suppose we should possibly start getting into some of this Game Awards stuff.
Game Awards. Now, the awards for these Game Awards, the actual trophy-type things with the wings on it and stuff that they're giving away to the winners, were crafted by the Weta Workshop.
New Zealand spin on this?
Yeah. We've always got a little bit of something going on when it comes to Hollywood and gaming. And
so
of course, the awards are still going on. We don't have a Game of the Year winner yet.
No.
But we've got some pretty big ones that have been announced so far. The first winner of the evening was actually probably my favourite out of this list we've got here. Best performance in a video game went to Trey Parker for South Park, The Stick of Truth.
Yes. He beat out Kevin Spacey.
Yeah.
Kevin Spacey, of course, played one character, whereas Trey was, he did about 9 or 10 voices.
Yeah. It's an amazing game. Have you played it? Yeah.
I have had a play on the PC, yeah.
It's hilarious. I loved it.
It's good.
Yeah.
Because you put in your name, what you want to be called, you select your name.
Yeah, you get no choice.
And then he just calls you whatever he wants. So.
Yeah. Okay, best soundtrack went to Destiny, which I only recently started playing.
I haven't played Destiny yet.
Yeah, I've only just started playing it. It's an awesome spin on a first person.
So it's a big orchestral soundtrack, I'm
imagining. Very big orchestral. A lot of money and effort has gone into this. So definitely a valid winner. Best mobile has gone to Hearthstone.
You know, I hadn't heard of Hearthstone.
I haven't played it. Don't know it.
But apparently it's really good.
And it's also in the running for Game of the Year.
Yeah.
So it must be a great mobile game.
Yeah, I don't know what their criteria were for Game of the Year.
Yeah. Best fighter, I will let these guys have it. It's not my favourite fighting game or my favourite fighting franchise.
Because there's no wrestling involved.
Went to Super Smash Brothers on the new Wii U.
Oh, yeah, fair enough.
Only because...
It's got a good name.
In the last year, there hasn't been a new Street Fighter or a new Mortal Kombat or anything, so... I think it deserving. Let him have it.
Yeah, there is a new Street Fighter coming, though.
Oh, I know. I saw that. Street Fighter 5 coming out to PS4?
Yeah, apparently it's going to be exclusive to Sony and PC.
Yeah, we'll see how long that lasts.
Street Fighter 5, confirmed by Capcom. We don't know if that exclusive means that it's only going to be on the PlayStation and the PC.
Or is it just an exclusive first release?
Or is it just exclusive launch date?
The thing with Street Fighter games is they release the first one, and then they'll release Turbo Edition, and then Arcade Edition, and then Super Edition. So you always get... You get four versions of the same game for about 5 years.
Yeah.
So
and
maybe they just...
throw it all together on one special disc like they've done with Halo.
That's pretty much what they end up doing.
Yeah.
So I'd say that Sony might be getting the first iteration.
The Hadouken collection.
Can't wait.
Back to the gaming awards.
Okay, now this one here was the one that we were but unhappy with, both of us. Best racer / sport title.
What do you guys reckon? Best sports racing game.
Okay, so in the last year, you've had the new FIFA game came out for Xbox One on release.
Yes. There have been a lot of sports ones. you've got your NBA.
All the 2K titles.
All the 2K titles. The FIFA one, of course.
The racing ones. This year has been a massive game for racing games. A massive year for racing games. Like you've had the new Forza.
Forza Horizon 2.
Yeah.
Forza Horizon 5 came out at launch.
Forza 5.
Forza. Yeah.
Forza 5. Forza Horizon 2. We've had the new GT, Gran Turismo.
Yep.
I'm trying to... Drive Club.
You've got The Crew, I suppose.
Yeah, The Crew. I'm not sure if they may have just missed out on even being eligible because it's only just come out in the last week.
I suppose so.
Yeah. But you've had all these amazing sport titles, all these amazing racing titles, and the winner of the award went to Mario Kart 8.
Yeah.
Which is not a real racing game. I wouldn't put it in
there's
sport.
There's definitely racing in there, but it's hardly... Oh, no, I guess, unless throwing turtles and stuff is a sport.
Yeah.
Out of the back of a car.
Yeah, I don't agree with this choice at all, this one.
No. I mean, great fun, yes.
It is an awesome fun game. I'm not taking away that element at all.
No.
I still play Mario Kart 64 on the original Nintendo, and I love it. Me and my kids sit and play it. But, it's a tough one, that.
I think that it's, yeah. Maybe there was too much of the good sort of sim games, and they went, we can't decide, let's give it to Mario Karts.
Maybe.
Maybe it was a consolation winner.
All right, the other one we've got here is Best Shooter.
Best Shooters.
And it's been a big year for shooters too.
Well, some of these games cross over a lot between racing and shooting and so on and so forth.
Yeah,
so,
well, I mean, GTA, where does that sit?
Not on the shelves at the warehouse. not on the shelves at Target or Kmart in Australia.
Yeah.
Probably not on shelves of other stores globally as well, as apparently the public don't like it.
They don't like GTA.
No.
The sales of the game tend to disagree with that statement.
Yeah, and it cracks me up that it's been available for a whole year.
Yeah, they wait till the next gen.
Made all their money, and then they go, oh, yeah, we're going to listen to the public now and make a moral decision and say that that's not a very good game. It's a bit of a misogynistic type thing, and it's bad, and it's mean to women.
And if you've been listening to Hashtag Radio over the last 2 weeks, which you have, you'd know that we have already issued the way of fixing the misogynistic issue.
That's right.
And it's by putting male prostitutes in there, so it's not a sexist thing.
Yeah. And as for violence against women, I'd say 99% of the people that I run over or shoot are blokes.
Yep. Definitely, I'd agree with that. anyway, we're still. So you've had out of the best shooters, you've had.
Oh, you're the best shooter. That's what we're talking about.
Yeah, that's where we came from. So back around to the
Call of Duty Ghosts.
That was in the last 12 months.
Yeah,
yeah, it was probably the last sort of might have snuck in there, but you've also got Advanced Warfare.
Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, which I've been playing a lot of hardcore domination.
Yeah.
It's great fun.
Destiny?
Yep.
Yeah. Have we had a new Halo?
Halo 5's not out yet. Not out. Master Chief Collection might have squeaked in as a... I don't know.
There's been a few shooters, though, this year.
Yeah. I mean, there's lots there that we've not mentioned.
Yeah.
You've got all sorts of other games that involve a lot of shooting. I mean, even Sunset Overdrive and stuff like that.
Yeah. Another big one. So the winner, anyway, was Far Cry 4.
Far Cry 4.
And I'm going to say I agree with this. I'm not a first-person guy. I got into Advanced Warfare. However, all week this week, I have at least put an hour into Far Cry every day.
I haven't got Far Cry 4 to play.
It's good. You should come around and have a jam one day.
I should, but you live too far away.
You got a car?
Yeah. Seen the price of gas, man.
Never mind. Whole different debate. So, yeah. What do you think of these awards? Do you agree? Do you disagree? Send us a tweet.
I've been quite happy with the results, except for Mario Kart 8 for the best sports or racing game.
That's
a load of rubbish.
So, there, of course, these awards are still on at the moment. We'll chuck something up on our website with all the winners and who won and took out these awards later in the week.
Indeed.
Now, there was a couple of things that we did still have to squeeze into the show.
Yep.
And one of the things is the free games for PlayStation and for Xbox One.
Xbox One and Xbox 360. Xbox Games with Gold, free December 2014. The Xbox One game at the moment is Worms Battlegrounds. Now, you've probably heard of the Worms games. They were pretty popular back
in
the day.
Been around for a long time.
So this is the latest and biggest and brightest version, high-definition 3D visuals with new additions to the single-player experience, so you can dominate the globe with exploding sheep.
Awesome.
Not a bad game. Certainly a specific type of game that you have to be into, but hey, it's free, grab it. On the 360, we've got... At the moment, The Raven, Legacy of Master Thief, which is set in Paris in 1960.
I've played that. It's a good one.
The Raven's a thrilling crime adventure set over 3 episodes. Full of twists and turns, it combines a whodunit with the risk and rewards of a heist story. How does that sound?
That sounds awesome.
Sounds free.
Yep.
Yeah, that one's available now for the 360. And coming later this month, from the 16th of December... You can hit the slopes in SSX, the snowboarding game from Electronic Arts. First released back in 2012. The idea of this one is to survive and look good doing it.
Yeah.
You get to ride slopes on mountains all around the world, from the Himalayas to New Zealand.
Oh, New Zealand, doesn't it?
New Zealand features in
this. I always used to love the snowboarding games.
Same. Cool Borders.
Cool Borders was ace.
Let's reminisce back to those PlayStation 1 days.
Yep. Okay, then also 1080 on the Nintendo 64 was good too.
Oh, see, I didn't have a Nintendo 64.
But neither, but I used to rent it every now and then.
I just love Cool Borders.
Yeah, Cool Borders was awesome.
And so those are the free games on Xbox Live for the Xbox Live Gold members. Also, the December system update is not very exciting at all. If you've got your auto updates, you will have already downloaded it without realizing. On the Xbox One, that is. And they're basically Xbox officials delaying any new features to avoid any possible issues over the holiday season. However, for the new year, they are looking at introducing screenshots.
Okay.
So you can take screenshots. And Phil Spencer, the big boss man at Xbox,
yep.
His personal mission is to improve the install times when you're installing games.
Oh, nice.
That's something he's personally wanting to improve. So
that needs to be improved across both platforms.
Yeah, so nothing of note for the December update. It's all behind-the-scenes stuff.
Yeah, PlayStation recently got an update as well, and it was pretty much the same. A few stability issues fixed, and that was it.
Yeah, they're just tightening everything up so that they don't get angry people buying exactly. consoles at Christmas.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, PlayStation Plus instant game collection freebies for this month.
Yes.
Now, this is the first really good one, I think, for the PlayStation 4. For the last few months, they've just been sort of indie titles, nothing big and major.
Mm-hmm.
There's been some great ones in there, but
yeah.
no big titles.
What is it?
The first one is Injustice for the PS4 and for the Vita, which is a DC comics game.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. It's an awesome game, too.
It's a proper game.
It's a proper game.
Yeah.
It's actually made by the same. It's made by NetherRealm Studios, who are the same studio that makes Mortal Kombat.
There we go.
Yeah,
Mortal Kombat.
So it's a big title, which is 100% free on the PS4 and the Vita. Secret Poncho, which is an indie title available on the PS4, as well as Titan Attacks, which is available on PS3, PS4, and Vita, and that there is like an HD version of Space Invaders.
Oh, true.
Yeah,
Titan Attacks.
So if you just want some quick sort of fun.
So it's just an arcade game, basically?
It's an arcade, yeah, basically an arcade game, and so it's free. There is a big title available on the PS3 as well, which is Hitman Trilogy, all three of the Hitman titles.
Oh, that's a classic. I'd be into that if I had a PlayStation.
Exactly. Well, I don't have a PS3 either.
Krista, hook me up.
Deadly Premonition, available on the PS3, and Final Horizon, available on the Vita.
Okay, and the last bit of gaming news for me, a couple of little things that I've found today. Konami's Metal Gear Solid 5 are introducing a multiplayer.
Okay.
Now, that game, is that out yet? Is it out?
Not 100% sure.
I don't even know if it's released yet, but they unveiled today their Metal Gear Online Tactical Team Operations, which is a new part for Metal Gear Solid. It's always just been a one-player game.
Yep.
Also, Mario Maker is coming to the Nintendo 3DS.
This one's quite a cool game. We talked about this during Gamescom, where they sort of teased it and showed a bit of it. And
so you get to build your own Mario levels, so you can create however you want it to go, bouncing on turtle thingies and collecting coins and going ba-ding, 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 as much as you want to.
All right, just going to quickly interrupt you here because the game of the year has just been announced. Dragon Age Inquisition.
Dragon Age
Game of the Year.
Congratulations to the people who made that.
Now, I'm just going to put my own personal opinion in on this, and I think it's an actual crime that GTA 5 didn't win or was nominated.
That's right. It's bound to have been the biggest selling game of the year, surely. I don't know who judges these game awards, though. I mean, I'm guessing it's industry folks who are scratching each other on the back and patting each other on the bottom and saying, oh, good job, good job.
Maybe it is a fact that they've gone, like, a GTA 5 doesn't need any more attention.
I think
they've made all the money.
Yeah. But, I mean, if it was like the People's Choice Award, do they do a People's Choice Award?
I don't know. I don't think they do.
They should.
Yeah, maybe they should.
They should. They should have a whole range of People's Choice categories.
That would be dangerous, though, because if you let them do the nominations as well, you know, there's a massive amount of World of Warcraft players and stuff like that. And like, how long is it? How old is that game?
Yeah, but you could do it by genre categories. Yeah, has to have been released between this date and this date, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
One other thing that has been confirmed for me as well, not gaming, but very close, Marvel's Deadpool movie has been confirmed by Fox.
Oh!
So Fox Studios have confirmed Ryan Reynolds will be the lead in the movie.
See, this is the one that was trending on social media for like the last 6 months.
Yeah, that little short tester that they did.
Which was awesome.
And it looked brilliant. And, I mean, he was... Ryan Reynolds played Deadpool in the Wolverine movie?
Yes, and it was terrible. He was terrible in it.
I'm not blaming him.
I'm not blaming Ryan. I'm blaming the writing of that Deadpool character. It
didn't fit with the feel of the rest of the characters in the movie.
I mean, it was cool having Deadpool show up.
Yeah.
But.
So that's set. The movie release is set for February 2016 at this time. And I've always been a fan of Ryan Reynolds. He's a fine looking gentleman.
Hmm.
And when you mix violence and comedy and good looking gentlemen.
I tell you what would be cool.
You've got my attention.
As if they have him on the next Avengers movie. That's due to get released, isn't it?
Yeah, and I think they might be teasing it a little bit.
Well, that's what I mean. In those Marvel movies, they always tease the next movie with a bit of a cameo.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And wasn't he in one of them? Or was it just the X-Men one that he was in?
It may have just been the X-Men one, which is a different studio. The X-Men aren't allowed to be in.
In Avengers?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because they don't own the rights. Same as Spider-Man.
Oh, poor old Spidey.
Spidey's all on his own over at Sony.
Yeah. And then Batman gets to hang out with real superheroes.
Yeah.
He doesn't even have superpowers.
But he's not a real superhero.
No. That's what I'm saying.
You say wearing a Batman t-shirt.
He's just a rich dude.
Yeah.
Cool toys.
Exactly. Anyway, we're waffling.
This is my favourite part of the show, is when we waffle.
There's a few things I want to plug before we take off. In the next couple of weeks, we're going to be doing our third annual hashtag awards.
Yep. We've just bagged everyone else's awards. Let's do our own.
Yep. We've got the most impartial awards of the year, though.
That's right.
Yep. We're only us get to choose who the winners are.
We choose the nominees and the winners.
Yep. So we've got that episode coming up. I think that's our New Year's episode.
I think so.
But before that, we'll have our Christmas episode, and I think we're going to have the guys from Access Granted and Gus from Bits of Awesome join us on that show as well.
Yeah, and possibly a couple of other contributors from the hashtag me.co.nz website.
Yeah, so I think for the Christmas episode, we'll probably wrap up the year that was for hashtag.
Yeah.
Because it's been a huge year for us this year.
Some highlights.
Yeah.
Some lowlights.
Lowlights, I can't really remember many of them.
No. That's because I wasn't at a lot of those things.
Yeah.
Which would make my lowlights.
Ah, yes. So, yeah, make sure you keep listening to Hashtag over the next few weeks. And we've also, for the Christmas episode, we'll have our Secret Santa.
Oh, yeah, Secret Santa.
Yeah, NZ Secret Santa.
And just tweet us or Facebook us if you need a postal address to send gifts to for Christmas.
Yes, we will accept anonymous ones, whatever.
Yeah. We'll give you a shout-out too if you want. No worries.
Anyway, that's just about us for another week. If you're after any of our podcasts, make sure you head along to hashtagme.co.nz. If you've got some time on Monday morning, make sure you head along to the Hour of Code at Vision College, brought to you by PlayStation and by Hashtag Me Podcast Network.
Mm-hmm. And, of course, if you need some Apple goodies to either make your own Christmas or that one of someone else's,
yeah,
get along to Yubi at Tiawa, the base.
Yeah, make sure you use the discount code hashtag.
Yeah, and they will discount the code.
Yep. anyway, thanks for listening. Thanks to Yubi as well.
Yes, indeed.
And we'll be back next week.
See you.
#me.co.nz.
For more episodes of this community access radio show, please visit freefm.org.nz. Thanks to New Zealand On Air for making this podcast possible through funding the Access Internet Radio Project.